Hello friends, welcome to a new video of Let's Watercolor with Vanidas. In this series of videos, I will take you through my way of doing watercolors. My objective is that jointly we make the watercolor painting a fun-filled and very dynamic activity. Hope we will enjoy.
Today we will be trying to make a painting out of this reference. The scene is a little bit simple here. We have this kind of a boat and we have a little bit of foliages that is far away, and some couple of houses or structures here, and we also have some kind of bridge sort of thing here. We'll try to make a painting out of this. I may not include all the details here. I may just suggest something here. This particular trunk I'll probably totally remove, and maybe one or two poles I will create just to add interest. And this particular bridge, the bridge is almost touching with the bottom edge of the foliages. Actually, it is creating a little bit of confusion. The top of the bridge is not seen at all. I'll bring this bridge a little downward so that we have a distinction between the foliage edge and the bridge. Now it is creating a little bit of confusion. I might add a little bit of cloud or something. That's it. Let us make a very quick sketch of it. Okay, if you look at the reference, there is very less sky. I mean, maybe even lesser sky. Maybe the top line is the horizon. Maybe here we will have some little bit of foliage. So maybe here we have some distant some houses or something. Not too much, something we'll suggest, okay, and a little bit of foliage here. Now let us take somewhere here, we'll make the bridge, and now we'll have to make the boat here. So the boat is reasonably big. And here you will find lot of reflections. Now we have suggested the boat. Now we will have some suggestion of the land here. Just some suggestion, okay. And now we need some pole or something. And maybe another pole here. I think we are this is okay with the boat. Maybe just to add some interest, maybe we'll keep some character. What we would do is we would probably make some clouds or something here, some variation in the sky, and we will gradually make this water darker and darker, and we will define some ripples and all, and then we'll finish it. Now we will make a drawing in the watercolor paper. We'll make the drawing very, very loose, as I always say. I not make the complete drawing here. I make it a very, very loose drawing. Of maybe I will define the sky somewhere here. It's very, very loose. This needs to be little kind of a straight line. Some foliages, just very, very loose mark, okay. And here, very close to that, we will make that the bridge actually. Now coming to the main object, which is the boat. This is somewhat where I want the reflection to be. Okay. I think we are done. This much is enough for the drawing part of it. I will have to go for the painting process. Okay. This is my palette. This is how I arrange my colors. Okay. Ultramarine blue, cerulean blue, cobalt blue. Yeah, this is another dark blue which I may not use. This is Camelin blue, right? I may not use it. This is violet, sap green, olive green, and some burnt umber, raw umber. Then this is burnt sienna, crimson lake, orange, Indian yellow, yellow ochre. I may not use all these colors. Regarding the brushes, I'll be using a big mop brush. Okay. This is number 6 Rafael. I might use a smaller mop brush, number 2 Rafael. I might also use some small round brushes. Okay. And I'll use a liner brush as well. First of all, I'll use a very pale yellow ochre. You can see it is very pale, very watery. Okay. And I want the bottom, the horizon area should be a little warmer. So I am using it here. So I am first applying it here. Okay. Maybe I will continue some of the water area also with the same color. Okay. And now I am going for some cerulean blue. Again very pale. Okay. I am starting from here. Okay, I'm rubbing the brush, kind of, okay. I'm rubbing the brush and I'm somehow mixing it to the pale yellow that we have already made. So at the top of the sky, I might add some more bluish color. Maybe I'm mixing little bit of cobalt blue and a touch of violet. Okay, and maybe I'm just applying it somewhere. Yeah. I'm using the belly of the brush and then dragging it. I'm allowing little bit of merging to happen. Okay, so little bit of pigment will come down and it might create some interesting effect. I'm changing to smaller brush and again taking the same violetish cerulean blue. Okay, and maybe I want to enhance some of this clouds. Okay, I'm just making some marks. I'm just making some random marks and allowing it to merge. Okay. Now, I think we'll have to quickly come for the water area. See, there is some water droplets here. So, I it is better if we can take it out. It might create some problem later. So let us make some water. For the water, what I am using is we already had some yellow ochre here. I want a little bit of greenish color for the water, so I am mixing it with a little bit of sap green. Okay, a little bit of maybe cerulean blue. Okay. And a touch of sap green. Yeah, I'm just it went too green. Maybe I'll apply a little bit more blue. So these kind of mistakes might happen. So what you can do is probably dampen the brush. I took a little bit of blue color and unloaded some of the pigment. And I am just kind of dragging it. This is cobalt blue. Just trying to make some correction now, because our previous mix went too much of green. I wanted a little greenish, but I think I have made a mistake in judging it properly. Cobalt blue, little bit of sap green I'm mixing again. I'm kind of painting around the board. This is somewhat, in this painting I am using little fresh colors. Thicker pigment. I'm using a round brush and kind of suggesting some ripples. This is burnt sienna. I'm taking quite an amount of burnt sienna. Some thick consistency. And maybe taking a little bit of yellow ochre. And I'm just applying some wash here. So I'm just sprinkling some plain water here, just to create some texture. Okay, we'll have to wait until this gets dry. Now this is dry, so we'll apply the next layer. Still our foliage drawing is still visible. So what I'm planning to do is make that edges little softer. So what I do is I'm just applying some plain water here. Okay. Plain water here. And taking whatever the blue color mix that we have here. Basically, it is some of these colors that I have mixed. What I want is little bluish color. That's it. So let us define those foliages now. It is just some suggestion. Okay, you know. These are not anything that is precise. Remember here somewhere we had some buildings and other things. But remember that the bottom edge of this should be little precise, little straight line. I'm softening some of these edges with some damp brush. Okay. I'm sprinkling some water. Now we'll have to make this boat. Then once this boat is there, maybe we'll decide whether we need to go for this particular bridge or not. So if you look at the reference, this boat was reasonably darker, and it was a lot of shadows were falling on this, little shadowish. So what I'm planning to do is, rather than keeping it very wide, I'm making little yellow ochre color here and mixing it to whatever the burnt sienna mix we have. Yeah, very light tone. And I'm making some, I don't want any sharp white here on the planks. See, we have drawn wooden planks here. So I want to paint around those planks, but I don't want any bright colors there. So by the time we paint this side, the darker side, I am expecting this to get dry. Okay. You have to decide what color it should be. I'm thinking it to be bluish itself. So again, for here also, I will go for some violetish, violet and cerulean blue. So we already have cerulean blue here. We are not going for too much of colors here. Okay. One little darker blue. So I'm using little cobalt blue to this. See, this is too light. See, I'm using a mop brush for this. It may be little difficult to get real control with the mop brush. You can use a smaller brush. Somehow I prefer to take this mop brush, and I, for some reason, I prefer to ignore quite a bit of mistakes. I don't really worry too much about some mistakes happening. I'm more happy getting some bolder washes. I'm just damping this brush. And I'm kind of taking out a little bit of paint here. Okay. The idea was to get some color variation. Now we will have to define the reflection. See, the reflection should be little. See, the water here is little greenish white, a greenish blue. So I will use similar color for the reflection also. Cobalt blue and sand green. I want some darker color here. We'll enhance it a little bit more, but we wanted some more darker tones here. Okay. It is not dark enough. Again, with this blue, I'm adding a little bit of violet, and I'm adding a little bit of burnt sienna, some little bit cobalt blue to make it a little darker tone. Particularly this area where it is touching the water. Now we have to make a little bit more reflection here, okay? So I'm taking a little smaller brush. we have to make this edge now. Taking a little bit darker blue now again. Maybe. See, what matters is actually the tone, not exactly the color. It is some kind of a negative painting or something, basically. Changing to a nylon brush, I wasn't getting good control with that. I don't really want too much of hard this ones, so I'm applying a little bit of spray here. Okay. So it is just to get some texture, let's say. Okay. With this small brush, I'm making some ripples at that distance. Very light tone. Little darker tone and making some see, this is all just some suggestion of some movement there, okay. Little bit more darker tone and making some of this will dry lighter, so you don't have to really worry too much. Now it's dry. But now what I think is here it has gone too down. I mean the shape of the board, because I think we have sprayed it and it pulled down the pigment little bit down. So I think we'll have to correct. May add little bit more darkness around the bottom of the board to correct it. And we will add some more details on the board, right? Then we will have to decide really whether we need to keep the bridge here. As I'm talking about whether we need to keep this particular bridge or not. I am still in a confused state whether I should put this or not. let us see. So to add darkness to this, what I will do is, I'm taking a damp brush and I'm just slowly, without applying much pressure, I'm applying a wash here so that I don't get any hard edges. I'm taking ultramarine blue and little burnt sienna. I'm dampening the brush and softening the edges a bit. I think we'll keep it there. See, adding this dark tone on the top of the I think we'll keep it at that. It will do a lot of things, but we'll keep it at that. What I want is little dull blue. Let's make the pillar for this. Just pressing with tissue paper, a damp tissue paper, just to diffuse some portions. I don't want it to be too little bit of blue, cobalt blue. See which blue you take and all, you decide the tone, you look at the tone and decide, okay. Let us add the reflection for this pot. Adding little bit more reflection with the mop brush. Okay, now let us make some character. So to get the character now, we'll have to be a little careful. So I'm just roughly drawing the character, okay, because I want to be a little clear about the size and all. What I am taking is cerulean blue, and I have touched a bit of white here, okay, just to make it little bit more opaque. Little darker tone. Taking some direct orange here. Darker tone, thanks. See, this all I really do not know what these things are, but some element to add interest. think we are mostly done. We'll add a little bit of accent to this area. I think we are done. Mostly we are done. I think I will finally use some white touches, just very very small touches, okay. See, these are just suggestions. Okay. this is the final image. Let us sign. Okay, we are done. Take out the tape now. So this is the final image. So we reached here from this image. So from the reference we made this particular sketch, and from this sketch we have made this. We haven't done it in a very detailed or very precise way. If we wanted, we could have paid a lot of attention to the boat and made it more precise here. So I know these are not dark enough now. We could have given a lot of additional importance. But I think overall it works well. So that's it for today. Let us meet in the next video. Thank you very much.
That's it for today. Hope you were with me throughout this video. If you have any comments, suggestions, questions, please do mention them in the comment section below. If you like my video, please click on the thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I will strive to produce more videos with your support and motivation by addressing all your comments and suggestions. And I will also try to respond to your questions, suggestions as frequently as possible. Hope we'll meet you in the next video, and we'll continue with the fun of painting watercolors. Thank you very much.